हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। दिस इज रामदास पंडित बरसठ वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन केमिस्ट्री एट मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाज नासिक। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी एग्जांपल्स बेस्ड ऑन पीएच एंड पीओएच। सो हाउ वी हैव टू सॉल्व दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम दैट वी हैव टू सी in this video. So first of all, we have to see the first example, which is based on pH. You will see here buffer solution containing 0.25 molar acetic acid and 0.50 molar sodium acetate. So calculate the pH of buffer solution if ionization constant of acetic acid at room temperature is 1.82 into 10 raised to minus 5. So we have know in this example the concentration of acetic acid is given here, okay, and concentration of sodium acid is also given. And one more thing, ionization constant of acetic acid at a room temperature, that is given 1.82 into 10 raised to minus 5, and we have to calculate in this example pH. So we have to use this formula: pH is equals to pKa plus log in bracket salt divided by in bracket acid. Okay, we have no meaning of the bracket, the concentration of salt and divided by the concentration of acid. And in this example we have no sodium acetate is the salt, okay, and the acetic acid is the acid. So the concentration of salt will be this, okay, and the acid concentration will be this. So we have to simply, first of all, we have to write the given data in this way. You will see acetic acid concentration is given 0.25 molar, okay, and sodium acetate concentration is given, that is 0.50 molar, and ionization constant of acetic acid, that is given 1.82 into 10 raised to minus 5. And formula also we have written here. We have to calculate pKa, okay, and how we can calculate pKa, that is we have know the ionization constant of acetic acid, that is the Ka. So we have to take simply negative log of that Ka, you will get pKa of acetic acid. In this way you will take, okay, pKa we are going to calculate, so is equals to minus log of Ka, okay, and Ka is given, okay, ionization constant of acetic acid, that is the Ka. So we will take minus log 1.82 into 10 raised to minus 5, so the answer will be 4.74, okay, so that is the pKa. Now you will see in this formula pKa we have calculated, plus log concentration of salt is already given, that is, okay, and concentration of acid also given. We have write in this way: salt concentration 0.50 molar, acid concentration 0.25 molar. So we have to simply put that value into this formula like this, okay. pH is equals to 4.74, that is the pKa value, okay, plus log 0.50, that is the concentration of salt, and 0.25, that is the concentration of acid. So you will get this answer, for this answer 0.3010. So we have to add both values, 4.74 plus 0.3010. So you will get the pH for the buffer solution, okay, that is the 5.041. okay, so in this way we have to simply we can calculate the pH. So if you will get, okay, like this answer. Now we have to see the second example, which is based on POEH. In this case you will see, calculate the pH of buffer solution obtaining by mixing 50 ml 0.1 molar ammonium hydroxide with a 50 ml 0.02 molar ammonium chloride. If ionization constant of ammonium hydroxide is 1.82 × 10⁻¹. Okay, again you will see in this example, ammonium hydroxide concentration is given 0.1 molar, and in this ammonium chloride concentration also given, and ionization constant of ammonium hydroxide is given. So we have to calculate here pH here, and after that we can calculate POEH. Okay, so first of all we have to calculate POEH. Okay, and for the calculation of POEH we can use this formula, that is POEH is equals to PKB plus log in bracket salt divided by in bracket base. So and here the concentration of salt is given, which one is here you will see base ammonium hydroxide, okay, NH4OH, and the salt is NH4Cl. okay, so we have to write given data in this way, right? Ammonium hydroxide concentration is 0.1 molar, ammonium chloride 0.02 molar, okay, and the ionization constant of ammonium hydroxide, that is 1.82 × 10⁻¹. So in this way we have to write given data. Now first of all we have to calculate PKB, because we don't have PKB, okay, but we have KB, okay, we have KB, ionization constant of ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide is the base, so we can say KB, okay, and if it is acid, so we can write KA, okay, so B because of base. And we have to write here PKB is equals to minus log KB, so we have KB, that is ionization constant of ammonium hydroxide, okay. So we have to take simply log of that values, okay, minus log. So you will write minus log 1.82 × 10⁻¹. So you will get this values 4.74. So that is the PKB, okay, value, okay, ionization constant of ammonium hydroxide. Now you will see here concentration of ammonium hydroxide, that is 0.1 molar, and the concentration of ammonium chloride, that is 0.02. Concentration is already given in that, okay, but you will see both are mixed together, okay, so we have to calculate that, okay, concentration for the salt. Salt will be ammonium chloride, okay, so 50 × 0.02, that is the concentration of ammonium chloride, okay, and total volume is 50 plus 50, so that will be the 100, okay, so in a total volume 100, okay, in a 100 ml of this solution, what will be the concentration of ammonium chloride after mixing? So you will get this answer 0.01 molar, okay, and like this we have to calculate for the base. 50, that is 50 × 0.1 divided by 100, So after calculation, you will get 0.05 molar. So this is for the base and this is for the salt concentration, right? Now both concentration we have to put into this formula, okay, in this way. We have got pKb, okay, and plus log of 0.01, okay, that is the concentration for the salt, divided by 0.05 molar concentration for the base. And if you will take the log of 0.01 divided by 0.05, so you will get 0.699, that is the minus 0.699. so you have to minus from this value 4.74, okay, so the you will get 4.041, okay. So this will be the pOH, okay, and we have to calculate pH. So in this formula we can put this value, okay, we have to calculate pH. So we can write in this way, is equals to 14 minus pOH, okay, and you will get 9.959. so in this way we can calculate pH and pOH also, and pKb, pKa also, okay. So we have to remember this thing like this. Now next topic we have to see, that is salt hydrolysis, okay. So it is the reverse of neutralization reaction. Neutralization, okay, you know what is my neutralization reaction? If you will add acid and base, okay, you will get the neutralization reaction, okay. Neutralization reaction means equal pH will be there, okay. And you will say neutralization, the combination of acid and base to yield salt and undissociated water. As I told to you, when you add acid and base, okay, so you will get the salt and undissociated water, okay. Now what is mean by hydrolysis? And salt leads to the formation of acids and base in presence of water. If you add different solution, okay, in that it will form, salt will form the acid base, okay, in presence of water. So in this way we have to see this, okay. Now the phenomenon of interaction of cations and anions of salt with H plus and OH minus ions by water yielding acidic and basic solution is known as salt hydrolysis. So the cations will be positive charge ions and anions will be the negative charge ions. They will interact with the H plus and OH minus, okay. So the cations having positive charge, it will interact with the OH minus ions, and anions having the negative charge, it will interact with the H plus ions. So like this interaction will be occur in this process, salt hydrolysis, okay. Now they are divided into four types, okay, types of hydrolysis of salts. And that the first one is salts of strong acid and strong base. If you take strong acid and strong base, okay, it will form salt, okay, like this KCl, NaCl, KNO3 and NaNO3. So they are the example of strong salts of strong acid and strong base, okay. All they are salts from strong acid and strong base, okay. And the next one is salts of weak acid and strong base, okay. If you will add strong base and weak acid together, so you will get like this salts: KCl, CH3COONa, Na3PO4 and Na2CO3, like this salts you will get. Okay, this is the second types, and the third types is salts of strong acid and weak base. If you add strong acid and weak base, so you will get NH4Cl, calcium chloride. Okay, calcium chloride and NH4NO3. So all they are examples of salts of strong acid and weak base. Okay, if you will add strong acid and weak base, you will get this kind of salt. Now next is, and the last, salts of weak acid and weak base. Example, you will see CH3COO, NH4 and NH4Cl. Okay, if you will add weak acid and weak base, okay, so you will get this kind of salts. Now we have to see hydrolysis of salts of strong acid and strong base. If you will add strong acid and strong base, the times you will get the salts. Okay, so that the hydrolysis of that salt we have to see now. Consider, for example, the hydrolysis reaction of salt of strong acid and strong base. If you will take the KCl in an aqueous form, okay, so it will dissociate what in water, K plus and Cl minus. Okay, so and water is also present, so it will dissociate like this, H plus and OH minus. So they will convert into ions, cations and anions. Now the overall reaction process will be like this. See here, KCl plus H2O, we have mixed together both KCl plus H2O. So dissociation will occur, H plus, okay, OH minus, K plus and Cl minus. So this will be the overall process, and here only ionization of KCl, okay, no hydrolysis reaction here. So here will be ionization of KCl, will be there is no hydrolysis reaction because salt of weak acid and the strong base do not undergo hydrolysis process. Okay.